So in our previous video, we were able to add the add to cart button inside the different products that we do have here. And when we click on the different places, we're able to click add to cart, but we're not able to see our items because we've not themed our page very well. So in this video, we're going to add the mini cart here so that people can see what they shop, and it automatically goes to this section. So let's jump into the code. Now inside our editor, I'm just going to expand it so that we have full real estate. We are going to similarly use this WCGet template, and we're going to apply it to our front page in the section where we're supposed to have our mini cart. So in here, I'm just going to overwrite this, and then I'll close off my PHP. I'll tap this to make it just look a little bit nicer. And the template that we are looking for in this particular case is the one when you go to WooCommerce, go to templates, go to cart, and then you're able to see the cart.php, but we also have mini cart showing up here. So we're going to reference the mini cart. Now, if you're not sure what's happening here, you can go back to the previous video, or you can just open up your plugins directory on your server and then check your WooCommerce, drag it and drop it to your editor, and you'll see that we have the templates folder in there, and in there we have the different files. So in the templates, we are looking for the cart, then we are looking for the mini cart, and that's what we're going to have there. So I'll save this, come back here, reload, and you're going to see that now we have our mini cart showing up here. So we have the images, we have how many of these do we have. We can view cart, we can check out, and if I click add to cart here, you'll see that we've just added 5 more roasted pumpkin. Let me just add a drink. I want some soda, sorry, fresh juice. I'll click add, and you'll see now we have fresh juice. Let me add this chicken kebab. I'll click add, and you'll see that we have our chicken kebab showing up here. So the shopper can have their experience right on this page by you just modifying and throwing this inside your theme. Now, for now, you can see that we are depending on the template that is in the particular WooCommerce site, but we can also get this very code of the mini cart right here, copy it, and just drop it inside our own folders here. So in WooCommerce, we are going to create a new folder, call it cart, and then we are just going to copy the mini cart from here, and then paste it inside our cart. So I'll paste this, and so we'll have the mini cart, so that if we want to make any change to our mini cart, for example, I'm going to just add an H1 tag here to just show us that we are working in the right file. I'm going to shout out mini cart right here, and then I'll just come back to our preview, reload this, and you'll see that now we are working from our own theme, and we can make changes to this without the worry that whatever WooCommerce does with that, their own particular file, we are safe and our website is not going to change or break, or customers have an experience that they do not know about, which we have not implemented. Maybe we upgraded the plugin to a different version and there are changes in that template file. Those changes will not affect us, because we have added that template inside our own theme. So we have just this one line of code, add this little file in here, and everything is working out great. So all we need to do is just style up these different sections, and then we're going to be having our shop look like what we have here. So let's jump into the bootstrap section of this and then just style everything up so that it looks really good. So I'll start off here by adding a div with a class of row, and then inside here I'll just add a div with a class of call-4, and then I'll just duplicate that and then get this to be with 8. So in here, in the individual sections as well, add the different pieces. So our image, I'll push it up to here. And of course, we need to write some alt tag for this, so I'm going to add PHP here. And then I'll allow us to just echo. So we'll add wp-get_attachment, and we're going to look for the caption. And the post ID we want to get, of course, is get the ID. So I'll copy this, get the ID, so that we can always just use the caption to name to give someone an idea of what's happening. Let's say they have challenges with the visuals, so you have to work with also people who are visually impaired. So we can have our screen reader just read out the alt tag by getting it from the attachment caption that we name inside our admin when we go to that particular image. Let's say this image, when we are uploading it or when we're in the media library, we can give it a particular caption in here so they can read that. So we'll go back to the front end here, and then we'll just clear up these last pieces. So I'll put these individual pieces inside this shell, and then clean up whatever we need to clean up here, save, come back, reload this, and you'll see that now this is looking a lot better. I just need to move our add to cart in the far side. So I'll just do the same, I'll duplicate this here, and I'll change this to have something like 1, we'll make this 7, and then we're going to have our add to cart in this section. So then we'll just cut this template that we have here, write PHP tags for this, and then just dump it in there, and then go and check out what happens. So save this, come back, reload, you'll see we have our add to cart showing up here, and it's starting to shape up and look like what we wanted to have here. So the only thing missing is the price, and we can get that also from our own template. So if we go back in here and check WooCommerce, if you look inside the templates again, you're going to find that in the loop we have this price, and it just shows you a span with a price, and it gives you the HTML of that. We don't need to rewrite that, so all we need to do is come here to the loop, just need to copy our price from the loop, go back to our templates. So in WooCommerce we create a new folder, call it loop, and then inside loop we are going to paste our loop right there. Of course add to cart is supposed to be in the loop, so my bad, I need to fix that so that it's in there. Then we'll modify, we'll get a chance to modify it. So that was an error I did before. So we have the pricing in there, and then all we need to do is just close up all these things, come back to our front page, copy this PHP line we have here, I'll duplicate this, and then since we are working with the pricing file or the template, we're going to change this to price, and then save this. When we come on the front end here and reload, you'll see that now our customers can see the price, the beginning price. Even if they go to pieces like pizza where you have differences in prices, you're getting all this information, and you can quickly add to cart, or you can even remove from the cart. And of course that's taking ages because we've not triggered the Ajax to work directly from our mini cart right here on the front page. So let's fix that. And I'm going to use a different method of bringing the mini cart, where we just use the WooCommerce mini underscore cart function of WooCommerce, and that's just going to bring in our mini cart. So I'll save this, come back here, reload, and then let me just add a few more items to our cart. When I click to remove this, however, when I go back to my code in here, and then I do a div, and then add a class of cart contents, I'll tap this inwards, and then I'm going to add another div with a class of widget shopping cart content, and then I just move my mini cart in there. So I'll move this option, move it up, tab it to make it work, and save, then come back here, reload this. I'll just try to remove this quickly. When you click it, you see this is responsive in terms of our actions very well. This is a little trick that I found that it helps remove the cache in the fragments and so on. So it makes it quick for you to just do these little pieces of things. And then your Minikat is working and you have a one-page experience. So the whole goal of this is so that your customers can shop from here, do whatever they need to do, then hit checkout, and they are able to quickly go and do whatever they're supposed to do. So in this case, I don't want people to view the cart because they've already viewed the cart here and they can also sort of edit it from here. So I'm going to remove the view. So of course I can hide this with CSS to make it disappear, or I can use some of the hooks embedded in WooCommerce to make this disappear. The easiest would just be get the forward button. So I'll just display this as none, and that would take it away. But then choose the one that has checkout and make it display block. So we'll have that showing up and having the other one go away. The reason why the WC forward made everything disappear is because the class is attached to both of these particular buttons. So we can have our mini cart just having our checkout, so that when you click checkout here, we're just going to go to our checkout page, which we're going to work on next. Now, of course, with the fixing of our mini cart, you don't have to worry that you cannot change the template. If you come to your mini cart inside your theme here, you can still make changes to this, and then when you come to your front end and reload, they're still effective. So just because on the front page we used this new method instead of using the template, we can still work with this function to show our cart and still make our changes effective using just the simple function that we have here and these few classes attached to that particular page. So let's fix our checkout page and its fields, and also add some CSS to make our template look a little bit better. Don't forget to like the video if you've seen something new that you love, and subscribe to the channel if you are new here. Otherwise, see you in the next video.